Before taking this course, many people believe it will be a math or statistics course. In reality, I think it's much more like a foreign language course. Let me explain. In exactly the same way many people in America use the English language to communicate with each other in an infinite number of ways and over many different channels, you will learn to use SAS programming language to communicate with SAS, complete with its own structure, vocabulary, and unfortunately, occasional miscommunications. It may be helpful to think of the SAS programming language in a hierarchy. At the top level are programs. These are specific conversations we have with SAS for a specific purpose. Programs are made up of steps, which are made up of statements. Global statements affect the entire SAS environment and remain in effect from one data or proc step to another. They stay in effect until changed by another global statement or the SAS session expires. There are two types of steps in SAS, data steps and procedure or proc steps. In general, data steps are used to manipulate data and proc steps are used to produce reports. Data steps begin with the keyword data and procedure steps begin with the keyword proc. Both generally end with the word run. Finally, all steps and by extension all programs are made up of statements. All statements end with a semicolon. As you will likely come to find out, if your SAS program is not running correctly, there's a good chance it's because you left out a semicolon somewhere. Statements can begin in any column, and they can span several lines. Because a semicolon determines the end of a SAS statement, there can be more than one statement on a single line. However, this is generally not recommended. And finally, there are comments. If the program is your conversation with SAS, then comments are your inner thoughts taking place during the conversation. Comments don't actually mean anything to SAS, but they will be extremely important for you. As an example, here's the program we just ran in SAS. It contains a sequence of steps, each of which performs a specific task. Let's break this program down into its component parts. As you just learned, there are only two kinds of steps in SAS programs, data and proc. The kind of step you use depends on what you're trying to accomplish. In this data step, you're taking a raw data file, processing it, and creating a SAS data set. As a general rule of thumb, SAS data sets are the only form of data that SAS can make use of. So, one of the primary purposes of a data step is to create SAS data sets. However, this is not the only function that data steps serve. More on this to come. The proc step, on the other hand, is typically used to perform some task with a SAS dataset. This may include performing calculations, creating reports, or creating charts. The two proc steps shown here are creating reports. Keeping in mind that there are only two kinds of steps, data and proc, and that data and proc steps always begin with the keyword data or the keyword proc, how many steps are in this program? There are three steps in this program. One data step, and two proc steps. The data step creates a new temporary SAS dataset called work.newimps by reading in data from the raw CSV file called newimps. The proc print step creates a listing report of the work.newimps dataset. The proc mean step creates a summary report from the data contained in work.newimps with statistics for the variable salary over each level of the variable job_title. You should also notice that all three of these steps end with the keyword run. As I said earlier, all steps are made up of statements, and all statements end with a semicolon. So, how many statements make up the proc print step in this program? The proc print step in this program is made up of two statements, a proc statement and a run statement. Now, how many statements make up the data step in this program? The data step is made up of five statements. As previously mentioned, because all statements must end with a semicolon, they can span more than one line, like the length statement and input statement in this data step. You may also notice that statements can begin in any column of the editor window. There are also two global statements in this program. What keywords do the two global statements in this program start with? In this program, the two global statements start with the keyword title. Global statements can be inside of or outside of data or proc steps, and can affect more than one step. For example, the first title statement creates a title that appears on the reports generated by both proc steps. The second title statement removes this title from any step that follows. Let me be clear about something. You don't have to memorize all of this now. If your head is swimming right now, don't worry. I promise you this will all be second nature by the end of the semester. For now, just make sure you're able to identify global statements, data and proc steps, and when statements begin and end. Finally, you should be aware of a few best practices before you start writing SAS programs. It's a common practice to start each SAS statement on a new line and to indent each statement in a proc or data step by several spaces. I find it convenient to use the tab key. Additionally, it's commonplace to add spaces between steps in your SAS code. As you become more experienced, you will begin to notice sections of your SAS programs, or even entire SAS programs, that can easily be repurposed by copying and pasting. This will also protect you from misspelling variable names. While this is a practice that I engage in often, as you're learning to write SAS code, you may want to avoid it. In my experience, the best way to learn to write SAS code is through repetition. Create a SAS program code template. Start with a title and some key header information, such as the date you created the code, the context for creating the code, and information about important modifications you've made. We'll walk through this together later. Finally, always make comments in your SAS code. I can't emphasize this enough. If this doesn't all make sense to you right now, that's okay. This lesson is designed to give you a general overview. In the coming weeks, we will back up a little bit, and you'll start writing and interacting with your own code.